to Copycats, the game show where copying is good.
It certainly is, because the aim of the game is for our families to gain as many points as they possibly can, because only one family today can go home with a special secret Copycats prize.
Shall we meet the families?
Let's meet the families.
OK, first off, we've got Rebecca's family from Liverpool!
We've also got Sam's family from Bedfordshire! You guys must be shattered after that entrance.
Nice one. Families, welcome to Copycats.
Oh. Now, Rebecca, you're the head of your family. Introduce everybody else, please.
This is my friend Lily, and she's good at dancing.
Hello.
This is Jack, my friend. He lives and loves cricket.
Nice.
This is my dad, Steve, and his nickname's Mushroom because he's a fun guy to be with.
Good
nice one. This is my uncle, Robert, and he spends more time getting ready in the morning than me. And this is Jack's dad, Gus, and he's an Aussie.
He's an Aussie?
I'm an Aussie.
Hey!
Don't need to say anymore.
He's an Aussie. OK, Sam, great name, by the way. You're the head of your family. Introduce your team.
This is my best friend, Abigail. This is my friend, Harry. He always likes playing on these game things. And this is my dad. And he likes doing pantomimes.
All right, cool. Cool.
And this is my auntie. She has a little kitten called Socks. And this is my mum. She has a full-time job looking after me and my two brothers, Oliver and Harry.
Hey!
Nice. Right, let's get this show on the road. The first thing we need to do is to decide who will be playing the first game. The way we're going to do that is Mark is about to mime something. The first family to correctly identify what Mark is miming will then get to choose whether they play first or second. OK, families, watch very closely. Here we go.
Smell a flower.
I was smelling a flower. Sam's family, you guys won that, so you now get to choose whether you play first or second. What's it going to be, Sammy baby?
Second.
Ooh. Well, Rebecca's family, you are going first. Let's play Copycats!
This first round is called Mime Time. Rebecca, I'm going to get you to choose one of these cards. You'll then have 10 seconds to mime the action on that card to the person next to you, which is Steve, and so on down the line.
Close the doors!
Close the doors!
Pick a card, Rebecca.
She's going for the blue one.
Oh, interesting. Interesting. Do you reckon you could do that? Nice one. All right, the best of luck. 10 seconds, starting from now.
Good acting. Good mind. Take a good look, Steve. Thumbs up from Steve. All right, Steve, your turn. Take a good look, Millie. All right, Millie, it's your turn. Go.
Nice spin.
A wink and a thumbs up there from Robert. OK, your turn. Jack's smiling. OK, finally, Jack, your turn. All right, OK.
Whatever it was, you were very pleased while you were
doing
it.
Yeah, nice one.
All right, for a maximum 50 points, Gus, any idea what Jack was miming there?
I'm going with golf.
50 points!
Well done! Nice work! Well, congratulations, Rebecca's
well
family.
Done, guys.
50 points!
Yeah! OK, now, Sam's family, Rebecca's family did really well there. They got the full 50 points. Abigail, how's your miming skills?
Good.
Good?
No, good.
Good.
Okay. Nice one.
All right,
okay.
Then.
The best of luck. Close the doors!
Close the doors!
OK, Abigail, you've either got to pick silver or red. Which one would you like? OK, silver. Have a look at that. OK. All right, well, good luck, Abigail. Your 10 seconds start now. Open the doors. Watching Kerry. Okay. Go, Good copy. Okay, Harry. Okay, Matt. Okay, Sam. To you, mate. Okay, looking a bit confused there, Hayley.
Yeah.
All right, well, for 50 points, what was Sam miming there?
Building a tower.
Oh, he was not building a tower. OK, we're going down to 40 points. Please open the doors. OK, Sam, what was Matt miming there?
Is it putting something on, like, a little picture onto the wall?
Ooh. It is not putting a picture on the wall. Good guess, though. OK, open the doors, please, for 30 points. Matt? What was Harry miming there?
Hanging out the washing.
He was hanging! 30 points to Sam's family!
Yay! Now, that does mean, Rebecca's family, you guys won that round, so you now get to choose whether you play or pass on the next game.
Now, before you start talking about it, if you go for the challenge and you successfully complete it, 50 points go to your family, but if you fail, 25 points go to Sam's family.
All right, Rebecca, you're head of the family. What's it going to be, play or pass?
Play.
They're going to play! Yeah. In that case, it's time to play Star Strike. Welcome to Star Strike.
Now, Star Strike is very similar to Tenpin Bowling, until you step onto the travelator. You do this, you step on the travelator, you throw the ball, and then you get off really quickly.
Excellent. Now, the aim of the game is to get those pins down. Now, you have to get all the celebrity pins down within the time limit to get the 50 points. If not, 25 points will automatically go to the other family for doing absolutely...
Yeah!
OK. In 3, 2, 1, go! You get the full 50 points!
Yeah!
Okay,
so the overall scores are Sam's family are on 30 points, but in the lead with 100 points, Rebecca's family!
Yeah!
This next round is called Quick on the Draw. Okay, Hayley, you are going to pick a card. You'll then have 10 seconds to draw whatever is on that card for the person next to you, which is head of the family, Sam, and then Kerry, and so on down the line.
Close the doors!
Silver, blue, or red?
Silver.
Okay, have a look at that.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Well, good luck to you, Hayley. Your 10 seconds start now. Open the doors. Keep watching, Sam. Okay, Sam. Kerry's looking a bit perturbed. Okay, Harry.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Abigail, for 50 points, what has Matt drawn there?
A tractor.
He has drawn a tractor, but that is not what we're looking for, I'm afraid. OK, can we open the doors, please, for 40 points? Matt, what has Harry drawn there? What are they, mate?
A pair of glasses.
OK, we need to be slightly more specific. OK, Harry, for 30 points?
Glasses for, like, reading. And
it's not, I'm afraid. OK, we're going down to 20 points. Kerry, what has Sam drawn there?
Sunglasses.
Sam! OK, anyway, well done, Sam's family. 20 points! Close the doors! All right, Robert, you any good at drawing?
We're soon to find out.
We will. All right, I've got two cards here, mate. Pick
I'll go
a card.
For the blue.
Blue. Get that in your head?
Yep.
All right, mate. The best of luck. 10 seconds start now. Take a good look, Jack. Not bad, not bad. Okay.
We ran out of time there, but maybe there's that. I don't know.
All right, okay. All right, Steve, your turn. It's not bad copying this. Is it not? All right, okay, all right. Rebecca, for a maximum of 50 points, any idea what Steve has drawn there?
A jellyfish.
Oh, it's so close, but it's not a jellyfish. OK. Steve, did you think that were a jellyfish?
Yeah.
OK. Well, we're playing for 40 points. We know it's not a jellyfish. Yeah. Any idea what Millie's drawn there?
I'd have to say an octopus.
It is! Yeah. So, well done, guys. You get yourselves 40 points. Family, you guys once again won that round, so you now get to choose whether you play or pass on the next game.
Now remember, before you make any decisions, if you take up the challenge and do it successfully, 50 points go to your family, but if you fail, 25 points go to the other family for doing nothing. Mm.
So, Rebecca, you're head of the family, what's it going to be, play or pass?
Everyone's telling me play, so I will play.
All right, okay. Okay, Rebecca's family are about to play Barmy Boot Shoot. Barmy Boot Shoot. Here's how this game works. Each member of our family have a remote control football boot. The aim of the game is for you guys to work as a team to dribble that ball there into that net there. Now, when you get a goal, we're going to chuck in another ball because
we're Barmy, we're Barmy. We'll call it Barmy Boot Shoot. We're Barmy.
Like this.
Like that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, right. Your aim is to get three balls into that goal before the time runs out. If you fail, obviously 25 points go to Sam's family. OK. Right, the best of luck. Three, two, one, go!
Go, go, go!
Oh, oh, hello.
Chance to hit the ball.
Yeah. It's not a roundabout, guys. Come on.
There we go.
Oh.
Got to let them work as a team. That's it. Oh, nice shot. You're playing bumping cars.
One big hit.
Oh! Nearly. Not that way.
Get out.
Great one. By the goalkeeper.
You just topped him up. Go.
Will's crying.
Here we go.
You didn't do it, which means
25
points go to Sam's family! Yes! Okay, Sam's family have got that 25 points. That means that their score is now 75, but in the lead with 140, it's Rebecca's family! Okay, Sam's family, this is the sound round. Now, Abigail, you are going to pick a well-known tune. You will then recreate that tune on this instrument. All right. Well, best of luck, guys. Close the doors! OK, Abigail, if you'd like to pick silver, blue or red for me, please. Go for blue, OK. Any idea what that is?
No.
No! OK, well, that's all right, cos we're going to play it into the studio in a second. Could everybody, except for Abigail, please, put their headphones on so that they don't hear what tune's been selected? Thank you. OK, are we going to play it into the studio now, Abigail? OK, good luck, darling. OK, your 10 seconds start now. Open the doors. Headphones on. Kerry, for the maximum 50 points, what was Harry doing there?
I don't know, match of the day.
Harry, what were you playing?
I have no idea.
That was fantastic. I can't believe that.
Yeah. You know.
Well done. Sam's family, 50 points. Now, guys, Sam's family got the full 50 points here. You feeling any pressure?
Yeah, definitely.
Well, good luck, Gus, and the rest of the gang. Close the doors!
Close the doors!
Now, can everybody except Gus please put your headphones on?
Well, the best of luck. Pick a card.
Thank you.
He's gone for the red one.
I don't think I know that one.
Really? OK, well, don't worry about it, because we are going to play it into the studio, so get the melody into your head, OK?
OK, yep.
Here we go. The best of luck, 10 seconds, starting from now. Open the door. Very good, Gus, yeah. Very good. Nice. Okay, Millie, your turn. Steve, your turn.
Oh,
well. Jackie Baby Chips and Gravy. For 50 points, any idea what Steve was playing there?
Happy birthday, dinner.
It's not happy birthday. Okay, no, we're playing for 40 points. Steve, what was Millie playing?
I haven't got a clue.
Not got a clue?
No.
Do you want to take a guess?
Congratulations.
It wasn't
great
congratulations.
Song.
Great song. Okay, we're playing for 30 points. Millie, what was Robert playing there?
What did I say?
You got
he
no
got
idea?
No.
No? Okay, well, no worries. We shall move on to 20 points. Robert, what was Rebecca playing there?
Laurel and Hardy.
No.
It sounded a little bit like
that popular tune, Laurel and Hardy. Okay, so for 10 points, Rebecca, Gus did a great job there. Any idea what it was?
I think I might have been when the Saints go marching in.
It wasn't.
Not.
Okay, Gus, do you want to tell everybody what it was?
It's The Promise by Girls Aloud.
Yeah!
And Gus did a brilliant job.
Yeah. Well, sadly, guys, you get no points there. Sorry about that.
Oh! I'll tell you what. Getting close now because Sam's family are on 125, but slightly in the lead with 140 points. It's Rebecca's family!
Yay! Now, Sam's family, don't you guys worry because it is still all to play for as we now go into our final round, Hamster Ball Havoc.
The big decider. There is only 15 points between the two families, and whichever family has the most points at the end of this race will go home with that fantastic family prize, everybody. Now, this is how it's going to work. Our families are going to try and get through this obstacle course as quickly as they possibly can without knocking over any of these balls, because every time they do knock over a ball, 25 points will be deducted from their overall scores.
Now, the first team to get past this finish line will win themselves 100 points. We've got Sam's team in the orange hamster balls and we've got Rebecca's team in the purple hamster balls.
OK. In 3, 2, 1, go, go, go!
So, team captain Rebecca has sent Uncle Robert off for the purple team and it's team captain Sam leading out the oranges. And Sam takes out the first pillar and that's a 25-point penalty. Sam looks like he may have got away with that little nudge of the pillar. Robert finishes the back straight and that's Sam not even out of the studio yet. Now, can Robert clear those penalty pillars for a clear first lap for the Purples? So, not only a clear lap, but a big lead handed over to team captain Rebecca. That's Sam still finishing his first lap as Rebecca clears the pillars on her first pass. Sam wobbles that same pillar again, but the ball stays on again. That's Sam's pal Harry taking over the second orange lap. Oh, hello, has he knocked that pillar? Yes, that's 25 points away. Rebecca charging down the back straight, extending her lead. Rebecca seemed to be heading straight for that pillar and that's the first purple penalty point. But she recovers quickly from that tumble. Oh, is that another one gone? No, it stays on, lucky. And that's Gus on the last lap for the Purples. Harry's been over. Oranges have got some work to do to claw this one back. Harry completes his lap and that's Sam's dad, Matt, on the last orange lap. And Matt stopped to say hello, but to be honest, Matt hasn't really got the time. Oh, So just the three pillars between Gus and the finish line. Here comes Matt, but it's too late. Gus crosses the line first. That was a great race there, Matt.
Close.
Nice catching up there at the end.
That was close.
It was very close. OK, now, Sam's family, unfortunately, you guys came second in that race, so you don't get the 100 points, and you did knock over two of the balls. So, Sam's family's final score of the day is 75 points.
Rebecca's family, you won that race, so you get 100 points. However, you did knock down one of the balls. So, Rebecca's family's final score is 215! Yay! Congratulations, guys. Here's what you've won.
Ever wanted to drive a big machine and dig up stuff? Well, now you can on this day out to a digger theme park for all the family.
Yay!
Nice one. Well, that's it, everybody. I'm afraid it's the end of the show.
Aww.
Sam's family, say goodbye.
Bye!
Rebecca's family, say goodbye.
Bye!
Join us next time on Copycats.
Playing Tracy Beaker is really good fun, but it's not real life. And I've always wondered what it's really like to be in care.
No, it'd be hard because I've never lived away from my parents before.
And I'll speak to people whose lives have been transformed by growing up in care.
If I could see a little version of myself now, I'd be like, keep on going, you can do it.
They're tackling some really, really hard subjects that most adults are even too worried to talk about.
The Real Tracy Beaker, a Newsround special, Friday 4:30, CBBC on BBC One.